The Legacy Fighting Alliance capped off an incredible year with LFA 96 going down from outside Wichita, Kansas. What is up, fight fans? Ron Kruk along with the UFC Hall of Famer Pat Miletich as we close out the Legacy Fighting Alliance 2020 MMA season, and we did it in incredible fashion. But Pat, first, what a year for the LFA. 17 events. They sent 46 of their fighters to the UFC alone. Incredible, once again proving they are the true feeder league to the UFC.
Correct, and we've never had a boring event. They've always, look, hats off again to the entire crew, but Mark Beery, the matchmaker, putting people together that make for close, tough fights many times, like you just saw in that championship fight.
Well, LFA in 96, the main event was the welterweight championship, and what a war it was. But to get there, we saw some incredible fights as well. And we will start off with the action in the middleweight division. Ryan Leyinger taking on Joe Holmes, who's also known as Ugly Man Joe. He made this into an ugly fight, Pat.
With a big right hand, he changed the tide quickly and then followed up. Boom, dynamite in that right hand, and kept throwing, and then the beautiful knee to finish.
All over Ryan Leyinger. Ugly Man Joe, third straight win, first career knockout, and first win in the Legacy Fighting Alliance. We move to lightweight division. Slava Borchev from Team Alpha Male taking on a Will Starks. This guy was in so a joy, Pat, to talk to. Intelligent fighter, and he took it to Slava early on.
I tell you what, both these guys got after it. It was a very technical fight. Very beautiful, I mean, beautiful wrestling by Starks. Well-balanced attack. And look at, it was a great fight. It was fun to call him, period.
Will Starks stops the Slava Borchev hype train for his fourth career victory. Then we went to the ladies, Mitzi Mary making her LFA debut against a determined Lisa Malton, who was coming off a loss to Sam Hughes back in January. She wanted to get back in that octagon quickly, had to wait, and she took out her frustrations on Mary.
Malton did a great job of balancing her striking with a lot of wrestling. Did a good job of that, controlling positions, underhooks. And I tell you what, really, it showed that she had probably tougher opponents in her background. And that's what paid off for her, as well as good strategy.
Malton gave Sam Hughes everything she could handle. She gets back to her winning ways, improving to 4-2. Former Ohio State Buckeye wrestling great Mark Martin taking on Matthew Calhoun from Jamaica. And the former Buckeye did what he does best, takedowns to start off this fight.
Definitely, and did a good job punching his way in, as you see right here, in on the legs again. Calhoun, a very dangerous guy though, was doing his best to stuff those takedowns, look for damaging shots, catching the kick there, landed some shots on Martin. Martin got a lot of experience in this fight and came away with a W.
Improves to 5-1. Does the MMA lab product head Benson Henderson in his corner. Mo Miller, another wrestling machine, looking to stay undefeated against Hegivaldo Carvalho, Pat.
Miller came out and showed the world that he is an absolute monster, repeatedly dumping his opponent on his head with these takedowns, traps the arm, boom, knocks him out finally. You do not want that man on your back. I'm telling you right now.
I was told on Twitter those aren't takedowns, those are punishing slams. And that's exactly what Mo Miller did to improve to 5-0. What a performance. Co-main event. Zach Jusola, the veteran of 17 fights, taking on undefeated Anthony Romero, making his LFA debut, and the veteran gave the youngster all he could handle.
He did. It was a close fight, back and forth. He pushed Romero as far as he could have pushed him. Back and forth fight the entire time. And I tell you what, the youngster getting that 9-0 mark, he learned probably the most of anybody tonight.
Split decision win for Anthony Romero, the Contender Series veteran, remains unbeaten. Well, a welterweight title fight for the ages. Maicon Mendoza looking for four straight. Batson Borel Daldorch making his LFA debut, and This was just an epic war from the beginning.
I mean, I shouldn't even talk over these highlights. No. These guys were in an all-out war, and as we said, there's the tide turner for a while. Dow Dort's landing that big left hand, but Mendoza repeatedly doing a beautiful job of giving just enough room and then coming back with those uppercut hooks. The brutal knees that I don't know how any man could have withstood, but there's another shot of those beautiful get out of the way of the left hand uppercuts.
The resurgence is complete. Maicon Mendoza becomes the ninth champion in the LFA of 2020, fifth straight victory, but none sweeter than this one for the welterweight title. We will kick off 2021 with two events in January. Make sure to follow the LFA on social media for all updates and a full schedule for the 2021 season.